Richard and Aisleyne are in the lounge.
We knew. We saw the two boxes.
You thought it must be.
We were like screaming, but we weren't too sure. And then when he got the first one, it was food. We were like, okay, no, maybe not. And then as soon as we saw you, we knew. And then we were thinking, out of the other box, was going to come like this big beefy boy. Because we're like, oh, look, a beautiful girl, we're going to get a big beefy boy. And then we're like, oh, no, shit, but it's
Ken
okay.
Ken and Barbie. It never happens.
Imogen and Sezer are outside talking about Aisleyne.
As soon as I met her, as soon as I thought, even the way she talks, she shows what she's about by the way she talks.
Oh, do you hear him? Intelligent.
Yeah,
she hasn't got a fucking single brain in her head.
I know girls like that. She's from she's from the same sort of place as I came from, and I know what she's about, and I know what she is. She's a girl from a ghetto who's had a bit of attention, flaunts her tits, and now she's up her own ass. But she's still a ghetto fucking hoe, and that's what she is. She's a ghetto hoe with a lot of opinions, and she is opinionated, and I will fucking bully more opinions out of her. And I'll make us look like a knob. Richard shows what he wants to do. He wants to get conflict with me. And he wants to go up against me. So I'll bully conflict out of her and Richard will defend her no matter what. And I think what he will realise, if this nomination goes to plan, if this all goes accordingly this week, I think he'll get a shock.
Fucking hope so. Can you see what he's doing? He's such a fucking dick.
I have to say, though, if we did nominations 2 days ago, I think I would have nominated differently to the way I might do now.
I see. I always knew I was going to nominate. Oh, we're not even on the top of this.
No, no.
But I knew who I was going to nominate from the word go. And it's still the same people. I'm such a good judge character like that.